This is always a challenging topic, challenging issue. That's why we usually include in the program specific sessions focused on this, because there are a lot of discussions needed and a lot of, let's say, points are still not fully elucidated. That's why there is a need for discussion on how we should manage this gray zone. So practically, the problem is that there are clearly benign schizoid tumors, Spitznevi, and there is no need to discuss anything about them. And also there are clear-cut malignant schizoid tumors, schizoid melanoma. And again, there is no need to discuss about it because we know very well how we should manage a melanoma. The problem is that unfortunately, in between these two extreme, these two edges, in between there is a group of entities which are difficult, or sometimes not only difficult, but impossible to classify safely as benign Spitznevi or malignant schizoid melanoma. And this is the source of the problem. This is why we have the problem. So, in summary, my recommendations, which were based on a recent consensus of that we did with other experts working on the field worldwide, was that in terms of clinical morphology, in order to avoid the risk of misinterpreting a melanoma as a benign Spitznevus, we should be extremely careful with schizoid lesions that appear on the skin after puberty, after, let's say, the age of 12, 14 years, because then there is a chance, there is a likelihood that that this lesion that looks like a benign Spitznevus is, in fact, a malignant melanoma. That's why the general recommendation is that after puberty, we should be extremely careful with schizoid-looking lesions, and probably the best solution would be to excise them. Then, concerning children, which is a very interesting category, because the majority of schizoid lesions develop in childhood, in children, the situation is a little bit more complicated. When in children we are in front of nodular lesions with schizoid characteristics, then again the recommendation is to be extremely careful and, if possibly, to excise the tumor for an histopathologic examination, because again there is a small chance that the histopathologic report will not be that this is a clearly benign Spitznevus, but there is a small chance that this could be either a schizoid melanoma, extremely rare in childhood, or an atypical Spitz tumor, which is not so rare as melanoma, even in childhood. Now, what is an atypical Spitz tumor? An atypical Spitz tumor is a tumor that the pathologist cannot safely classify as benign or malignant. Therefore, it should be at least surgically excised. So that's why nodules also in children should be managed with a lot of caution. While flat schizoid-looking lesions, the classic Spitznevus, the most frequent type of Spitz or Rig nevus that we find in children, these tumors can be monitored until the moment that they will stop growing, until the stabilization, because Spitznevi, we know that are very dynamic, they will grow rapidly, and then at a certain point, they will stop growing. And at that point, we can stop monitoring. And finally, last point was that in case of an histopathologic diagnosis of an atypical Spitz tumor, we know pretty well today that there is no need, there is no indication to do anything more than the simple excision to healthy margin. So there is no need for sending the lymph node biopsy, because the result of the sending the lymph node biopsy is not informative at all, even if it's positive. So it does not predict a poor outcome. The outcome of atypical Spitz tumor is almost always excellent. So the only thing we have to do is to make sure that the lesion has been excised in healthy margins.